Dear students, let us continue module 4. In this lecture video, we will be studying two topics. Parser-lexer communication, YAC parser and the rule set. So, how the lexer and parser communicate with each other? Lexical analyzer and syntax analyzer, how they communicate with each other. So, when we use a lex scanner and a YAC parser together, the parser is the higher level routine. So parser comes after the lexer. So parser is the higher level routine. It calls the lexer YYLex whenever needs a token from the input. So parser will call YYLex whenever it needs a token from the input file. The lexer then scans through the input recognizing tokens. The lexer then scans the whole input files and it will look for the tokens whatever parser has asked. As soon as it finds a token of interest to the parser, it returns to the parser, returning the token's code as the value of YYLex. So, as soon as the lexer will find the tokens of a parser interest, it will return that token to the parser and returning the token's code as a value of YYLex, and it will token code will be returned to the YYLex. Not all tokens are of interest to the parser. In most programming languages, the parser does not want to hear about comments and white spaces, for example. So actually, input file have so many tokens, but parser are not interested to get all the tokens in the input file. So it will choose, it will define what all tokens it needs. It will define in the rule section what all tokens it needs. So that tokens only lexer will send. So for example, ignore tokens, the lexer does not return so that it can continue on the next tokens without bothering the parser. So the tokens which it is not demanded by the parser, lexer will not send those tokens to the parser so that parser can continue execution further. Now the token in our grammar are the parts of speech. In our parts of speech, the different tokens can be noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition and conjunction. These are the tokens. YAC defines each of these as a small integer using a preprocessor, hash define. So YAC can define these tokens using the preprocessor hash define. For example, hash define noun, hash define pronoun, hash define verb, hash define adverb, hash define adjective, hash define preposition, hash define conjunction. So these are the tokens YAC can define. Then lexer will scan the input file. If any input which matches with these tokens, that value it will send to the parser. This is all. Now YAC. What is YAC? YAC, it stands for yet another compiler compiler. It is a kind of compiler. It is a tool which generates LALR parser. We already know LALR parser in the theory subject. Syntax analyzer parser, or syntax analyzer, or which is also called the parser, is a second phase of compiler which take input as token and generate syntax. So in the six phases of compiler, a syntax analyzer, it is the second phase, and which take input as a token and it generates the syntax tree. For example, let us see. Suppose you have written a YAC file with a name parser.y. Any YAC file extension should be .y, parser.y, and compiler. It will be fed up to the compiler, which is tool. So what YAC tool, it will compile this YAC file and it will create a C file called y.tab.c. Then C, since it is a C file, so that C file need to be compiled using the C compiler. So y.tab.c, it will compile. It will be compiled by compiled by C compiler, and it will generate a dot out. And this is only LALR parse, and this is only lexer. Now in this LALR parser or the parser, this input file, which is a token which I come from the lexer, it will be fed up to LALR parser, and it will send the output, that is the parse tree. This is how it happens. With this example also we can understand, suppose we have a program gram.yak file, gram.y, and yak compiler or tool, it will compile this yak file, and it will create a C file y.tab.c, and then it will be compiled by the CC compiler, GCC compiler, which will create a a.out file. Syntax, we can see that definition, percentage, rules, percentage and supplementary code. So this one, YAC has the three sections: definition section, rule section and supplementary code, which will be separated by two percentage. The definition part includes information about the token used in the syntax. The definition part includes information about the tokens used in the syntax. And so in the definition part, all the information of the tokens and syntax will be used. For example, in the definition section, we can have a percentage token number. Means we are defining number will be considered as a token. A percentage token ID can be considered as a token. Then YAC automatically assigns number of tokens, but it can be overridden by, it can also be overridden. Here, YAC automatically it assigns these tokens value, but it can also be overridden by, we can write like that, percentage token number 621. Now here 621, number value is 621, which is a token. Next we'll come to the rule section. First definition section, then a rule section. The rule section describes the actual grammar as a part of production rules or simply rules. So rule section, it defines the actual grammar, which is also called productions. Each rule consists of a single name on the left hand side of the colon operator, a list of symbols and action code on the right hand side, and a semicolon indicating the end of the rule. So there will be an operator before this colon operator, a single name will be there, that is called a production, that is called head, and right side of colon some symbols will be there, that is called action code. By default, the first rule is highest level rule. The first rule will be the highest level rule. This is the parser attempts to find a list of tokens which match this initial rule, or more commonly rules found from the initial rule. So using which we can find out the initial rule. Now for example, we have a program, write a YAC program to recognize a valid identifier. So any identifier, how we can recognize? Identifier should start from any alphabetical letter, right? So we are defining like alpha, it should be followed by alpha or digit with multiple terms of alpha or digit. This is the what definition of the identifier is. In this one, how we can write the grammar or rule section? So we write the grammar, S generates alpha A, where alpha is alphabet or digit, followed by digit. Now A here, what is A? A can be defined as A alpha or A digit or epsilon. So this A can be a letter also, or it can be digital. But first letter must be starting with the alpha, where alpha and digit it will be defined from the legs. Alpha will be A to Z, or small case, lowercase A to Z. Digit will be 0 to 9. This is how we can define. We can see in the